Hi Scorpios, welcome to my channel. So today we are going to do your reading from 24th of August till 30th of August, and we'll see what are the guidance messages for you in the coming week. For those who are new to my channel, a warm welcome to you all, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please consider subscribing and hit the bell notification icon as well so that you'll be updated about my latest videos. Alright, so as you all know, this is a general reading. It might or might not resonate with all of you. So let's see what is there for my Scorpions. Let's see. For my Scorpios, please. Three shuffles. I'll be looking at your past, present and future energies. Okay, so before starting the reading, I really want to thank all my Scorpions. So because of you all, I have reached 3.5k views in my past last videos of Scorpios which I uploaded, and this was my first video which ever got 3.5k above videos, and I just completed my 500 subscribers. So thanks a lot guys, thanks. I really appreciate that. You know, it was really something really wonderful for me, because I have been uploading my videos from such a long time, and this was the first video who actually crossed even 1000 views. Okay, so thank you so much. So Eight of Cups, so this energy is coming from past so many times in your readings, you know, leaving the situation. And I shuffled in front of you, so that's not my problem. So this is what you are going, and you know, things ending, everything like that. The same reading is why, I don't know why it is coming up again and again, but see, with this past energy of yours, Four of Cups and ten of swords, you know, your past energies, you have Ace of Swords as well. See, I did all the shuffling over here in front of you, and the same reading is coming up. All right, so with the Four of Cups and Ten of Swords and the Ace of Swords, it's like, you know, when you clarify things and when you actually put things to an end. So this is you who left this particular situation. This is all you. I know that, we know that. Yeah, so you know, where you have just ended the stuff, because you know, things were really coming up in front of you, and when the clouds start disappearing, see how this Ace of Swords, this lady is just, you know, she's actually seeing the clear sky. So this means that this you, you know, when you actually start seeing the actual clarity, or the when clouds start disappearing from you, the fog start disappearing from in front of you, and you are able to see the clear things, the whatever the situation is. This is what actually happened in your past. You were able to see everything, and you were not ready to accept the new cup, the new, you know, this offer of, and you were ready to move on. That is why. So you took your stand in your present energy with the High Priest, the World and Seven of Rods. So two cards out of three are major arcanas with the High Priest and World. See, really, this was a big change of your life, a really big change, I'm telling you. Things were really up down in your situation, and when you were, this is somewhere when you actually tried to take a stand of yourself, you know, where you want something. This is something like that. You want to take this stand, and you have taken this stand. You know, this is all about you. This is all about you. When you want to take a stand, why to hesitate? Because it's your life, your rules. That is what it is. So things are in your favor if you actually want them to happen, and they will not happen if you are not able to do anything. So this is life. If you are ready to take a stand of yourself, then go ahead. Why to stay back? Why to listen to some other people? Why? Okay? So this is that energy. Yeah. With the Queen of Rods, Five of Rods and Page of Cups in your future energies, we really need to clarify this. This is something new which is coming up in your life in future. I'm seeing that there's some kind of a competition. Might be you are a competitive, you are a person who is like, you know, two people in between one. So this is something like that. Might be dealing with the Leo over here, but we are going to clarify this energy in the future. Let's see. Why does the Eight of Cups is here in your overall? See, Five of Swords. Okay. Betrayals with the Emperor. Yeah. So whatever betrayals were there, whatever, you know, back bitching and people were there around you who were not, you know, who showed their real faces after a long time, after some time. And you knew that and you are like, okay, fine, I cannot hold this person anymore in my life. I really have to move on. And here you are taking a decision. Well, this is an Aries card, but this is you over here who actually took a decision. You took a decision. It was a very strict, stern decision. Yeah. Okay, so let's see this Four of Cups in your past energies. Why this Four of Cups is here? Queen of Rods again. So we have got two Queen of Rods. Okay. One more card, please, to clarify. Not so many cards. What else do we have? Okay, sorry. Ten of Wands. See how you were so much, you know, you're facing so much of problems, you were feeling that heaviness, that burden, that thing on you. You know, when you start feeling overloaded, when you are like, I am just able to handle two things at a time, and what you are giving me tensions, you are giving me 10 things at a time. How am I able to tolerate all these things? I am ready. So over here in your past energies, you were ready to offload these things. With the Ten of Swords, with the Ten of Wands, you know, when you start feeling overloaded and then you are ready to drop all these things, all those tensions, all those burdens from your mind. And what happens when you drop all the burdens? Things end. That is what happens. So when you actually, you know, you took a step that, okay, finally I am just offloading my tensions, offloading my problems, then things came to an end. And this is why, you know, then only you actually found the main thing. Because what things were not in front of you, when you actually, you know, when you try to give your 100% to somebody, and when there is a level which actually reaches a certain amount, and you know, when it's like it's full, this bucket is full, so it has to overflow after that. So at that point you found the clarity, you found the real thing, like the main reason why, you know, you were taking so much of tensions, you were taking so much of burden on you to just make things work, but it was not enough for the other person. And then only you found that clarity that, okay, so this is the thing. Like when I was appreciating you, when I was taking all your problems, then you were there for me. Then you were like, okay, I like you, I'm there. Like a friend, even when you are ready to be with a friend, that person is like, okay, I'm with you, I'm your dear friend, I'm your best friend. And when you are like, I am with so much of problems, please take some of my problems, then it's like, okay, I should run away. You know, then you actually, basically, you know, there is a quote regarding this. When in happiness, do not count people in your life. It's when the sadness, when the sad times come, when the bad time comes in your life, then you actually got to know which people are there for you, standing right beside you for your problems. And you saw that thing in your past, that the real faces of people. All right, so let's see why the present energy with the high priest. The empress is here. Yeah, I'm seeing that. So you were like, okay, so you got the mature, you got the clarity, and you were like, okay, so I'm able to see everything. Yeah, what else do we have with the empress? The knight of cups is here. Yeah. Anything else? The temperance, so many of major arcanas are coming up in your present life that, you know, you are basically, you know, this is the process from which you are going through. And this is a big, big story. This is a big moment of your life, which is actually, which just came to an end. That was really something which had to end. And now the main thing of your life has started. So if you are in your 28 and 29, so this is your Saturn return might be, because for some of you, just do check with an astrologer if you can, or your chart if you can, because this is a major shift in your energies I'm seeing. So you might be, when Saturn returns, so it brings a lot of things, lessons learned. So that is what is actually happening in your life right now. A lot of lessons have been learned. Let's see the World card. So it's time for you to celebrate now. So the things, the process has ended and you have taken a stand of your own. So everything has come to an end and it's your time to celebrate, to be with your friends and just have, you know, a good chit chat and basically a little of enjoyment. And the past has been done. You know, you are done with the past energies. Now it's time to rejoice. Now let's see, why is this Queen of Rods is here? I don't know why I'm getting a feeling that this Queen of Rods is the same person in your future as well. You might be dealing with a Leo over here. Or a Leo personality, you know. Page of Cups, okay. So I'm getting, see, Page of, okay, so I got it. Page of Cups is twice. Queen of Rods is twice, and it came with the Three of Swords. So there might be a lot of a big chance for you know, whose real faces were actually in front of you in your past energies. These people are really coming up, showing up in front of you at any time, because of the Page of Cups, it's instant. You don't even know, like a message just popped up. Oh my God, really? See how this fish is popping out from the cup? It's like the person over here is shocked to see this fish. So this is something like, oh my God, really? Now why? So this is that kind of a message, that kind of a sudden action or sudden thing which comes in front of you. This is a really unexpected thing is coming towards you, I'm seeing. Let's see why this Five of Rods is here. King of Pentacles, okay. And Six of Wands. So someone is coming to win you now. Okay, so that is why I told you the future energies are really different. Because I'm seeing that, you know, now they are really ready to fight for you. So this is something. See, Five of Rods in another deck, it's like five people are fighting with each other. But over here, it's more of a, you know, funny. See how these people are playing. And it's like a funny, not funny, it's like an enjoyable moment over here. So, you know, this person might be even fighting for your attention, you know, getting concerned, like, please reply me. They have sent you a message that please reply me. You might be in between two or three people where they are fighting for you to get you. This is that energy. With the King of Pentacles, now it's really coming. They are really coming up and, you know, they want a stable. They are coming with a stable offer. They are coming with a lot of maturity in them. That's what I'm seeing. I see with the Page of Cups again. So it's like they're not going to go really soon. Okay, so might be a Taurus with whom you are dealing. Taurus, I'm seeing over here. What else? Yeah, Two of Taurus. Sag, Taurus. Taurus, okay, what else? Leo, and Aries, Scorpio, Libra. Okay, so that's all. So that's all, Scorpios. That's all from my side. I hope it helps. And we'll meet you in the next video. Till then, bye.